Let's speak now to Senator Sonny Angara on the resolution filed by senators seeking the immediate resignation of Health Secretary Francisco Duque III over the Philippines' response to the COVID-19 pandemic. Senator Angara himself is a COVID-19 survivor, and he announced on March 26 that he tested positive for the virus and was discharged from the hospital on April 6 after recovering. The senator is also appealing to recovered COVID-19 patients to donate their blood plasma. Senator, thank you so much for joining us, and it's good news to see that you've recovered from COVID-19.
Thanks a lot, Denise. I'd like to greet good afternoon to all our viewers today.
Senator, you and 40 more senators have decided on that call on filing a resolution on the immediate dismissal of the Health Secretary. But President Rodrigo Duterte decides to keep Health Secretary Francisco Duque III despite all of that. What are your thoughts?
Well, you know, it was really just an expression of the legislative of frustration with the performance of the our health department led by Secretary Duque. We felt could have been more proactive with testing. We're lagging behind. Ideally, we in the quarantine and the lockdown, you should be doing massive testing to get a real feel for the situation. But medyo nag-lag behind tayo precisely because of the actions of DOH. Yung contact tracing is very important also in containing within a community. That's practically non-existent. We've not utilized technology as other countries have done. And worked with other agencies. So your coordination with other agencies, there's actually a lot of complaints from different sectors, no? We were just the mouthpiece, I think, for that. And we respect the president's decision. Kami naman, we just, whether, sabi ko nga, whether the secretary is removed or not, we just hope we will be more proactive in fighting this crisis. This is a war. Guerra talaga to. At we need good generals to lead us, Denise.
That's true. Senator, you mentioned that a lot of departments and also maybe institutions have been complaining with the lack of proactiveness with this. But what was the breaking point that you and the rest of the senators have decided to be the mouthpiece and file a resolution for this?
Well, I think it's to each his own, really, no? But for me personally, what affected me is that a lot of our hospitals were not getting the protective equipment that they deserve. Sila yung sundalo natin eh. Tapos, kumbaga, naiiwan sila sa labanan, di ba? Dapat sa gera, walang naiiwan na sundalo. In fact, the country does everything to protect them. Eh. Parang na-orphan sila in this situation. Sana hindi na mangyari yan going forward. I think the Senate has sent a message and we respect the President's decision.
And what other resolutions do you plan on filing? Just the other day, Senator Zubiri also was talking that you guys are in the talks about passing a law granting the president and the DOH to act immediately and stock up on essential materials as well as, you know, responding to other health threats in the future.
Yes, there's a need to be able to procure, in cases of emergency, to procure some medicines, no? And ako, I'm filing a resolution, don't laugh. It's about discouraging handshakes in our social gatherings, because in our professional and social dealings, because it's customary when you have a guest, when you have a visitor, you shake hands. We want to discourage that because I think World Health Organization unanimous that that's the quickest way to pass on germs. So really, it's a practical way, but seemingly harmless. Resolution, but it will do a lot of good, I think.
Senator, good afternoon. This is Ron Cruz. Hi.
Hi, Ron.
Nice to see you up and about, Mr. Senator. I just have one more question.
Much.
I just want to go back to the discussion about Health Secretary Francisco Duque.
Okay.
Didn't you think it was risky for the senator's school to call for his resignation in the middle of the game, so to speak, just at a time when we were actually entering the rapid testing, massive testing here in the country? Didn't you think it was risky?
That came into play in the senator's group chat, no? And some said maybe it's difficult in the middle of the game. Who do we put there? But we realized with all the complaints coming left and right, we had to do our jobs as representatives of the people. We had to voice out the frustration, which I think we did. And we hope there is a proportional response from the department and the leadership of DOH going forward.
And I'm sure you're not going to tell us who may have been recommended, but did you have like a consensus on who could take over the position?
Oh, wala, wala. Hindi masyado na pag-usapan ng senators yon. It was really more of a venting on the different issues where we could have done better.
And Senator, it's good to see you looking well and healthy, but how is the journey to recovery? And you know, you've also been very vocal about COVID-19 patients recovering to donate their blood plasma.
Actually, yes, that's what I've been trying to inject into all my interviews, Denise and Ron, nowadays. There's still a need. I'm getting a lot of texts from doctors and from friends saying there's a need, particularly for A-positive blood. And given the fact that a donor can only give 14 days apart, after giving blood, he has to wait 14 days before giving again. We really need a mechanism to organize the donors, because sometimes there's privacy concerns. Mm-hmm. The survivors of the virus don't want to reveal their identities.
Exactly.
Sana the DO, again here we want to see more action from the DOH and the hospitals, because right now it's an informal network of the hospitals talking to each other. But if the LGUs could also help, since they have they're the ones doing the contact tracing, and they're seeing where they know where people live, they know how to get in touch with them. If all these stakeholders could get together, mahaysa na yung process, because according to the doctors, it's quite urgent. Pag nakuha yon, mas malaki yung chance talaga na gumaling yung pasyente.
And thank you so much for that, Senator Sonny Angara. Thank you for joining us, sir.
Thanks a lot, Denise. Thanks a lot, Ron. Good afternoon.
Thanks, sir.